I will be fight any place.
Okay.
Even underground. But only with HBO.
Sergey, you're a knockout artist. We don't have a lot of knockout artists, and fans love knockouts. Why do you think there are so few boxers that knock people out like you?
Why they?
There's a lot of boxers, but very little knock people out like you.
Много боксеров, но как бы очень мало может нокаутировать как ты. Почему ты?
No, because I'm Sergey Crusher Kovalev. Maybe 34 right now.
But when you go into the ring, what point do you see the knockout?
I don't have a goal, knock him out, anybody, you know, like. I just go into the ring and make a fight. Make a fight. And when it's happening, yes, It's good for me. Less work, less job in the ring, more happy, and more happy for my fans. I'm very happy when it's happened, but I don't have a goal that I need to knock him out, you know. Like, when you want to knock him out somebody, you can't do it. Because your opponent can see your punch, your like, yeah, it's,
you telegraph.
Yeah, already experience say about it, and I just go into the boxing, and what will happen, it mean will happen.
So is anybody gonna
see from him?
There's still things you haven't seen because you haven't seen him in a real close fight with inside game. He hasn't used that yet, so there's still things we're working on. But you know, with Kovalev, I let him develop sometimes during certain fights, certain strategies himself, and work off of that. Because he's very intelligent, he sees things in the ring. So that's okay. You tell me what you see, I'll tell you what I see. And then we look at it, show me what you want to work on, and show him that's okay. Let's just add this to that. So he's very intelligent. With Bernard, he's seen things that I know of, and I said, okay, you see it? Let's do them, let's do this. Let's try it this way, though. And so he's very intelligent. He knows there are things that are still left to be taught to him. Yeah, you know, he's not a finished product by any means of imagination. You know, if he were to fight at Stevenson or Pascal, somebody else, they present different styles. Mm-hmm. You have to work on that. But to me, once he gets his inside game together, you know, but most guys, they're all just grabbing and clenching. Mm-hmm. There's no, you know, they're not just sitting back on the inside, just firing each other and rolling.
You were a very good end fighter. Yeah. If folks haven't seen John David Jackson fight, very good, a southpaw and a boxer, but he could fight on the inside. And I remember your uppercuts were very good.
Thank you. Most guys, they don't do that.
You're right.
I want you to learn that because he may need that. And on the inside, it does help you. And the crowd wants to see you just grabbing and holding the whole fight and the referee had to break it up. They don't want to see the ref. They want to see you fight. So to me, that's one of the things that we still have to really work on. Work on for this fight. He's going to need that for this fight. And it's out of 10.
What has he improved on, let's say, in the last three or four fights, let's say, since the Campillo fight? And that was kind of his coming out party. And then the very next fight, was it Cleverly? Or maybe there was one fight in between,
White, Cornelius.
So, looked great. And, I mean, has he improved since the Cleverly fight, since winning the title?
Yes.
What areas?
It's in his pursuit to chop you down and break you down and get close to you. You know, most guys are running. So he's just cutting the ring off really good.
Okay.
And once he gets close, he goes to the body. You know, he looks at that head, but he's hitting you in the arms, the forearms, you know, the kidney, but he can get away with it. He's hitting you with the body. His inside attack with the body punching is so much better now than it was when the first guy was. Because there was no attack.
Right.
It was all hit. And he realized the body is there to be hit. And with any fight, I might hit you in the head, but I'm going to hit you in the body because the body can't move as quick. So he's real good at that now, the body attack.
You know, what's the next step for him? I know you're saying the inside game.
Yeah.
Going into this fight, and I'm going to ask you for a prediction or whatever. What are the keys to being able to break down Bernard Hopkins, and what's your ultimate prediction for this fight?
The keys, you have to cut the ring off. You can't let Bernard dictate the pace, because Bernard will walk you around, jab, throw that right hand, and he pot shots you basically at this stage of his life.
Right.
So, you know, the kid has to be the aggressor, but not reckless abandonment or aggression. He has to be walk behind that jab, hit Bernard in his chest, but where do you even touch him? Don't worry about the head. You gotta keep testing one now. Once you're close, now you're there. Maybe you're fainting. Maybe you learn a little bit, and then you get. You know, but if you watch Bernard's fights in the first four or five rounds, he has a tendency to just leap in with his head because he's afraid, you know, he falls for your things. So the kids to be smart and realize the man's old, treat him like that. You know, so for me, I see if he does the things he needs to do as far as be patient. Don't look for the first round knockout or whatever. As the rounds go by, he'll get Bernard. Because Bernard, if the beach pass around, Bernard might get brave and say, you know what, I can get him. I'm getting him if these rounds going by. And he might get brave and get careless. As far as the prediction, I see Sergey winning. I can't say which round, because if he clips Bernard really good, I want to see what his chin is really made of at this stage of his life. If you're willing to withstand that kind of punishment. So, you know, it'd be interesting.
I got to put you on the spot. Is he going to be the first guy to stop Bernard Hopkins? If Bernard stays on a stool or somebody keeps him on a stool.
Let's see how he's a problem with Bernard. Let's see how proud he is. You know, if in the past you've seen him kind of, when he fights the first fight, another guy, he always claims he's hurt.
Right.
He might try to find a way. See, in the first round, I think Sergey, be careful. Don't get in a wrestling match with this guy, because that's his way, that's his option now. If he gets in the first round and really clips real good, you might say, damn, I got to find guys before four rounds in. Got the fifth round, there is no.
Yeah.